Welcome to another episode of No Looks Film Session. One thing I like to say is I felt it. I felt the spirit of Peyton Manning in Indianapolis. And I took the game within my hands and I scrambled it around and I made it my own. And shout out to the defense also. They went crazy too. It was just the culmination of the whole season right now, because a lot of our overalls are getting higher and higher. The game plan isn't just, you know what I'm saying, the game plan is also practicing and all that other stuff in the training. Depending on whether, you know, if you're a starter or not, depends on how hard your training is week to week. But because we have so many milestones after the game and then we going into the game plan again, you know, we get a lot of boosts, you know what I'm saying? Also, we do have injuries, but at the same time, the people that are on the field, you know, they're boosted up, you know what I mean? Like, they're not down, I'll tell you that. You know, after like a win streak like the one that we're on from week two, like it's way better than just like winning one or two games or something like that. Like, I'm telling you, man, the training's, it's really working at this point. It really is. So let's get into the game plan. But first thing is first, this is the last step before the Toronto Mounties. I know some of y'all voted whether the Washington Commanders or Toronto Mounties, you know what I'm saying, which one you wanted. But Toronto Mounties, they got their dome in Toronto. Just a FYI. All right, so we're doing a blitz counter. They have a blitz counter for first, second, third. You know, they're calling zone blitz all game. You know what I mean? So I'm just keeping that in mind and I'm moving like that. They have a lot of inside zone, even an ISO. They're just basically predicated off Jonathan Taylor. I mean, I don't blame them. You know what I mean? Like, he's a talented dude, just had 200 yards the last week. But if you look at it, you know, they're top 10 in rushing yards, but they're the bottom three in passing. So you mean to tell me if we don't take away Jonathan Taylor, Jimmy Garoppolo is going to go crazy? Let's get to the intro. Got some drags from the slots and the tight end. Giving it to Kendrick Osborne. I wanted to show you all this because he was one of the catalysts for our audible to a drag in. It's my first audible. Feeling real Peyton Manning this game. Giving it to Kendrick Osborne again. Usually this would be Antonio Brown's spot, but he's injured. So I had a similar play like this against the Bears. Nobody was open and I took the sack. This time, running the ball. You know what I mean? It's a different line. It's a different team. It's a different game. We're on goal line. I'm in the pistol. And whoop. Yo, I love this one right here.
I love that move. But yeah, got the ball again. Defense did their thing, three and out, giving it to Rashard Penny because Dalvin Cook is out with a broken collarbone. He'll be out for the next 6 weeks. Did a play action. Ha, he could have hit me, but you know, people pull up, their animations pull up sometimes when you're sliding. I like faked a slide and dope. Looked like he was mad about that. But and then you just run the ball right after that. Rashard Penny just, of course, same person tackles him. Getting into the goal line. Already up 7. Why not just give it to the running backs, you know? Madison letting the rain, clearing it out. What you know about that? All right, so now we're up 2 touchdowns, and it's the second quarter. It's not exactly like panic time, so they're still running the ball. Jonathan Taylor doesn't get that many of those this game. That was like one of the few. I audibled Justin Jefferson to a slant, and I'm so glad he did, or I did, because he was one of the ones open when somebody was about to smack my shit for the sack. So good on him. Still doing my Peyton Manning thing right here, calling hot routes, just making sure. And yeah, it clears out for Adam Thielen. Adam Thielen getting a first down. Okay, so of course one has to hot route, put Jefferson in the slant. Decided to run it anyway. Still getting that first down. We got slants here. It could be a zone blitz. I bet on a zone blitz, and it wasn't a zone blitz. So, I don't know. I was humble, yet confident enough to just take it myself. Let's break it down. So, as you can see, nobody's fucking open. If I try to fit it in a pocket, somebody can just easily get in that passing lane. As far as, like, the safeties and linebackers, they're kind of all within the same level in the middle. So you can try to fit it in if you want to, or you can just kind of turn around and react before they can. Boom. So we go after a field goal. Kicking it off. Oh, it's a fumble. We got the ball right before halftime. I didn't expect this. I really didn't. Jimmy Garoppolo is pissed. he is livid on the sideline. Oh man. So I'm putting somebody in motion. It looks like we're kind of doing an audible because people have to be on the line, off the line as far as receivers. Nope, just Alexander Mattison getting our first down. Come on, man. T.O. And that's what catapults us into getting the field goal right before the half. 27-0 with a pissed Jimmy Garoppolo. They're trying their hardest, 3rd and inches. Come on, man. We planned against you, bruh. We planned against you. So here I am, a little audible, Peyton Manning style. I see the first down. Not trying to do anything crazy. Like, we're up 27-0. Audible into a play action, straight ahead, 3rd and 7. I get smacked, but guess what? Adam Thielen. Listen, it's almost a cheat code when you have JJ on one side, Adam on the other side, Kendrick Osborne in the slot, and then Antonio Brown just waiting to get back. So I audibled Adam Thielen to do a corner route. I just happened to notice if it was a zone blitz, he would be open. it wasn't exactly a zone blitz, but at the same time, he was still open. So the person that audible or hot routed to, it's the person that's open. I make it look easier than it is, man. I really do. But everything's not default, you know? You gotta really... A lot of drops this game. I mean, I don't know what happened with that. I thought we were gonna have a shutout. In my head, I feel like it's a shutout. Because, come on, man. Look at this. Third down. Fourth down. You have a fourth and four. 6 yard line. Up to you. No. Come on, man. This is a shutout to me. Not only that, most importantly, I have no interceptions. So everyone who has interceptions this week, you feel me, can catch up to me, because I have, like, I know I have close to the most. Jimmy is mad. Oh fucking well, buddy. Alright, so 200 yards, Jimmy, not so good. I got a touchdown, missing less than 10 passing attempts, I feel like is a celebration, you know, worthy thing. No interception, celebration worthy. 70 yards, 71 yards. Jonathan Taylor shut down. A lot of carries between Alexander and Rashad, just to make up for Dalvin Cook. Adam Thielen, not many games he's going to be the leading receiver, but he has to be some games in order to be interested in this season. So one of the rare times he's just on top of J.J. Pauls. Kyler Murray, Ryan Tannehill, Von Miller, 4 sacks is crazy, I'm not going to lie. TJ Watt doing the same thing except 2 sacks and an interception. He's dangerous. Ryan Tannehill, the second Titan to get player of the week. First one was Derrick Henry. That was the film session. Can't wait till next week. Don't even matter who it is at this point. Let's go.